or later, but must, the dam will burst and everyone will break out. And we'll stop them. The force. Which force can stop this river of ones who already know their course? The force is a centenarian, and that is far too old. 150 years of brute force. Don't tell me them not cold. Them cold. What do we have here? Black History Month? Reggae Month? I love this month, but I don't worship the idea. Straight up, we'll use the time to clarify the year and strengthen the resolve of the African and all other freedom lovers. Mabra, news flash. Babylon plans crash. Thunder interrupt their program to announce. Black Electric Storm is here. Straight up, Mondays to Fridays, 9 till midday. Mondays to Fridays, News Talk 93 FM. I'm Robin Bongo Jerry Small. You're host, Straight Up. Yeah, good morning. Welcome to Straight Up for today. Today is the 5th of February, Friday, the 5th of February. And we're in the studio here of News Talk 93 FM. News Talk 93 FM on the Mona campus of the West Indies, at the University of the West Indies. And heard all over. Today is a day also preceding the birth date of Bob Marley. Not the birth date. The birth date is 1945. But the birthday anniversary of Bob Marley. And we expect to have some of the associates of Bob Marley here talking about that. I hear that there's a request to repeat the interview played on the previous program. An interview of Bob Marley in Australia sometime before he died, focusing on the use of ganja and the and other things, you know, Rastafari lifestyle. We have such a tight schedule today that we can't promise to play that today. Maybe Monday we play that. Being the whole month, being reggae month. Matter of fact, the first of February was Dennis Brown's birthday. I'll now not touch on Dennis Brown. But I want to correct some information that I gave yesterday. The Skillcraft Skibbo Avenue function, the annual function for years, for decades now, held at Skillcraft Skibbo Avenue by Brother Rupi Hylett and his associates, Jalov and Brother Paul Ned of Soul and all them other brethren. It will be tomorrow night, the 6th of February, Bob Marley's birthday, and not tonight as I had said. Not tonight at Skillcraft Skibbo Avenue, but tomorrow night. Several vital events being held tomorrow night, among them Miss Kemp birthday bash, celebrating 36 years in the music business at Spiegel's Lawn out at 6 Mile Mandela Highway. Also, I think, is it Errol Dunkley's birthday bash? There's a birthday bash at Ronnie Williams Center. I think it's Errol Dunkley, you know, is it? And Pam Hall is one of the featured artists. Pam Hall. Several very worthwhile events tomorrow night. Skillcraft, Bob Marley, Dennis Brown display right back till morning. Dennis Brown and Bob Marley music right back till morning. Miss Kemp bash out at Spiegel's place out at 6 Mile Mandela Highway. And the birthday bash, I think that it is for Dunkley, Errol Dunkley. May I be corrected that Miss Pam Hall is going to be one of the stars on that show. But the question is this. Pastor Harvey, the Adventist teacher, and I think he's a lecturer at the Northern Caribbean University and pastor of Adventist Church. I wonder if J.P. White out in Trelawney, there's an Adventist, like his fellow comrade Pastor Harvey of the PNP. I wonder if he's an Adventist or if is he a Catholic, because he's named after one of the popes, John Paul. Is he an Adventist or is he a Catholic? As is John Paul, Pope John Paul, the first and second. Is J.P. White, John Paul White, a Catholic or an Adventist? One thing I know, that White is said to have been guided by the PNP. Guided by the PNP to withdraw and resign. Guided by the PNP. And yet Paul Burke is denying that they told him to do so. They said that he arrived at that decision on his own. Them said that he arrived on this decision on his own. He came to this decision of his own volition, Burke said. And then John Paul White said, I was guided by the party. Is Pope John Paul guided by Mother Teresa Burke or not? You know, Perkins used to refer to Paul Burke as Mother Teresa, because was it Tommy? Yes, I think it's in Mother Teresa, as well as I think it's in Perkins used to refer to as Mother Teresa, as well as Dr. Blythe. I think both of them have heard been referred to as, am I right or am I wrong, according to Mr. Coombs. So we don't know whether it is a party telling for it, but it seems like it's a party telling for it, because the party coming in embarrassment, and the party knew that they were holy for money. Matter of fact, must be about 140 million tax, and later it was must be reduced to 17 million. They knew. But it's only because the public knew make them remove him. Only because the puss let out of the bag. Puss let out of the bag. So is he a Adventist like Harvey? Or is he a Catholic like his namesake John Paul? And it is said that White, in him net today paper, it is said that White was never popular among the comrades in the constituency. White was never popular amongst them. But he was chosen, I'm saying this now, he was chosen because he has money to spare. Like most of the candidates are chosen because they have money to spare. Whether it's money with them or with them a hold back. Or money with them sequester. Or grab out of the latter industry. Or money with them get from different places. Them. He was chosen because he had money to spare, like so many others. Like so many other choices, from St. Andrew Hills to Clarendon Plains, right back to Westmoreland. Chosen because they have money to spare. Not popular in the constituency, but the party send them out there because they have money for spear. They have money for spear. The petty bourgeoisie putting forward the big bourgeoisie. You understand? The petty bourgeoisie won't get big. So they must select out the big bourgeoisie with the whole heap of money for put forward. Let's hear from Derek Harriott way back in the 60s. John Tom. Is it?
Call me John, but no call me Tom, John Tom. Call me John, but no call me Tom, John Tom. Call me John, but no call me Tom, cause one man cannot name John and Tom. Oh, no call me so. Oh, no call me so. Mister, if you call your brother so. Mister, if you call your sister so. Mister, if you call your papa so. Oh, you are called John Tom. Please don't call me so. Call me Buck, but no call me Brian, Buck Brian. Call me Buck, but no call me Brian, Buck Brian. Call me Buck, but no call me Brian, cause one man cannot name Buck and Brian. Oh, no call me so. Me say fi call Audley so. Me say fi call Lydie so. Me say fi call Freddie so. Me say fi call Larry so. Me say fi call Trevor so. Me say fi call Keith so. Oh, no call me so. But no call me dog, dog face. Oh, it's call me face, but no call me dog, dog face. Oh, it's call me face, but no call me dog, cause one man cannot name dog and face. It's oh, no call me so. Are you a call face dog? Are who you a call face dog? I mean you a call face dog. Are who you a call face dog? Who tell you send me a face dog?
You look like dog, man. You look like a face dog, man.
And me, you must never look in a mirror yet.
This dog,
how you call this dog?
This dog,
how you are called this dog?
This dog,
Mr. Pecalio.
This dog,
Mr. Pecalio.
This dog,
Mr. Pecalio.
This dog,
approve, approve, approve.
straight up. Yes, that is Derek Harriott from way back in the 60s. I'm say, when that time said, you say if you call Audley so, but that was the days before Audley Shaw was even an adult. Way back in the 60s, John Tom. Yes, so there it is now. A juggle around, a changing and changing candidates, paying off candidates, paying off people with seats in of the House, paying off people with seats in of the House of Parliament. It's a long time tradition of Britain for pay off people by giving them seats in of the House of Parliament, and then them scrape money and give back to the party. If them hold back money and hold tax, them share the money with them hold with the party. Instead of them pay the tax, them share it up with the party. Them get scamming money, them get wallet money, them share up. Long time tradition from England, and them started, and PNP and JLP started. Long time tradition them inherit from their mama. In England, their mama. In England. Shameless. Well, now I remember now a similar election where them entrapped Bob Marley and make him get shot. Entrapped Bob Marley, the government of the day entrapped Bob Marley. They didn't intend for him to get shot. They entrapped him and used him in the election. And the other side shot him. The other side shot Bob Marley with the intent to kill. Now Claude Massup was a good friend of Bob Marley, you know, would never carry out such work. Matter of fact, Claude Massup was in prison at the time. Probably, I don't remember whether he was imprisoned under the state of emergency to get labor rights out of the way. Because the PNP did get a whole heap of labor rights out of the way, just like all labor rights the more time. Get a whole heap of labor rights out of the way in a 76 and put them in a detention so that them could have run them election. That time CIA, I helped labor rights, I compensate. But no, it wasn't help, wasn't enough. It wasn't as much as 1984 years later. Wasn't enough for them to catch up. But somebody labor right them now authorized Jim Brown to come shot Bob Marley, Jim Brown and others. And because Claude Massup was in prison, detained, that's how Jim Brown get to raise up, start him rising up to rise up over Claude Massup. Them start rise up Jim Brown from Claude Massup in a jail. Send him go shot Bob Marley. And by the next 2.5 years, Claude Massup is killed, murdered by arrangement between the two party. Murdered by arrangement. And Jim Brown finally become the number one. Now that Claude Massup out of the way. But the slogan of the PNP in 76, when they have the whole country under state emergency, was that them have we under manners. Them have we under manners. Heavy manners. That's what it means, you know, a bullying and a boasting. That you have people cornered. And you have them hostage, like what them want to take Portmore hostage. Have them under manners. Like how Tivoli and West Kingston was taken hostage for 43 years. And it continued after that too. So let's hear the origin of some of this have under manners slogan. Monty Morris from about 1962 make this music. That the children of today, them have no manners. They have no manners. Them go to them bed and them no send up prayers. And instead of them saying them prayers, them in the one room situation, watching mama entertaining her new boyfriend. Instead of them go to them bed after prayers, them a watch mama going on with a whole heap of things. But them no have no manners, and we have them then big youth, I think also Prince Farai come make a tune in the same 75-76 period. So we have them under manners. Both so the politician them have the country under manners. Not big youth so much, Prince Farai. But the original one is Monty Morris. Let us hear it. The children of today watching and peeping after mama.
Have no manners, because them go to bed and no say no prayers. Wake up in the morning after sleep retire, watching mama if she catching fire. Someone should ask why they do that. nothing in that. Look on your neck, look on your waist, raping every place. Look on your neck, look on your waist, raping every place.
That's Sammy Ismay, that saxophone there. Sammy Ismay play with the Dragon Ears, Byron Lee, but him play plenty for Duke Reed session them. Sammy Ismay after Baba Brooks get that terrific trumpet breaking in the middle. Children of today, them not have no manners. And go to them bed and not send no prayers. Watching mama, if mama catch up fire. Peeping for mama in the one room situation. Mama want have out her lot and mama there working a show with her new boyfriend and the children watching her instead of them go to bed after prayers. Them a watch mama if mama catch up fire. Shouldn't be doing that, have no manners. But to have them under manners. So the PNP used that slogan in 76. Have the people them under manners and a boss off. So them have them under manners, heavy manners. And I put some in the detention. And put me in the detention too. Because them put some of them enemy, political enemy in the detention. And Tony Spalding and others instigate them to come raid the Ethiopian World Federation Charter 15, otherwise known as the 12 Tribe of Israel, and detain 92 away. Because we will not endorse the PNP, we refuse to do so in 1976. Them raid the Eilston Road and carry 92 away go on no man's land. You don't understand? Because them want to endorse Tony Spalding in a concrete jungle. We was in concrete jungle. Them beat up a bridge and run him out of there. We move from there, and we go to Skillcraft for a while, and then we move to 12A up Eilston Road, collecting our dues. And them not like how the hundreds and thousands of us are gathered, and them cannot get us to endorse them party, neither the PNP or GLP. Tony Spalding and some of them friend them instigate police to come raid we and carry 92 of the males to no man's land over in a waterhouse there. So them have we under manners. And framing some of my brethren, them say them are labor right. Framing, just like when you hear some of the phone call them would want to frame Jerry Small. You may not do so. You may not do so. I can't fit in here for him. And none of us can fit in here for him. We can't hold in a prison. We can't hold in a prison. We fly the gate. And we fly the gate. So let's hear from Prince Farai, one of those that they use in the political thing for boast off that them have the population and the manners. Let's hear Prince Farai.
Manage you and to adopt discipline is what the world needs today, baby. Every discipline, you know. Oh, not you.
Everywhere you go,
every discipline I have. Well, watch your man. War in the east and a war in the west. War in the north and a war in the south. Crazy Joe, get them out. Tell you what a terrible bout, yeah. Tell you what a terrible bout. Crazy Joe, get them out, yeah. Natty Dread Doom Barrow, cause he member tomorrow. Him too like sorrow. Not the treat, don't trust, cause them don't like the rush, and them don't use the brush. Until you see a shiny brush, what a terrible brush, yeah. We out of sight, not the have of him height, not the have by sight, not the treat, don't fight, yeah. Well, watch your man. Not the good day and the discipline. Every discipline is what the world needs today, baby. Discipline, you know. Every and a every discipline. Every discipline, not the good day and a... Well, watch ya, man. Man is due to a dog. Discipline is what the world needs today, you know. Discipline, discipline, heavy discipline, yeah. Discipline is what the world needs today. And etiquette, you know. Cause one of the noblest things a man can do is to do the best he can, yeah.
Now when the government of the day, and Michael Manley government of 1976, entrapped Bob Marley, after Bob Marley volunteered to do a free concert for the people of Jamaica, the government entrapped him by printing the posters for the concert in them party colors, entrapped Bob Marley, and Bob Marley find himself in a box of bricks and demand that they must print over the posters in a neutral colors. For example, red, gold, and green. Them say them not do it because it's too late. And some of the laborites start to beg Bob Marley, say, don't do the concert because it's going to look like you're in the PNP. Bob Marley was on the PNP bandwagon in 1971-72 and did endorse them along with the Wailers and many more singers. But in 76, him passed that, him exceed that, and him graduate from that. And the laborites, them beg him, say, don't do the concert because it's going to look like you're in the PNP. Bob Marley say, him have to go through the concert. Claude, him has up there prison. Claude Massop can't do nothing about it, but Claude Massop refused to take any step against Bob Marley or to endorse anybody doing Bob Marley nothing. But Jim Brown was there, willing to take step on them, send him. Send him go shot Bob Marley, shot Rita Marley, shot the manager, and shot Louis Griffiths, the 12 Tribe of Israel vocalist. Louis Griffiths shot the whole of them, and try shot more. And then now when Bob Marley was rehearsing for the concert, singing up songs to boost up Jamaica, because Jamaica have a bad image and tourists never want to come here. Bob Marley sing a song to bring tourists come and name Smile Jamaica, you're in Jamaica, come and smile, everything is alright. And one of the lines in the Smile Jamaica, them give Bob Marley to sing, say, heavy manners in a Jamaica. Smile, you are in Jamaica. Heavy manners. And one time Bob, somebody, a certain person go to Bob Marley, when I have her permission, I will tell you. I will be able to identify her. A certain person, a lady, go to Bob Marley and say, what kind of thing that you are singing about heavy manners in this political time? Because the concert is supposed to be about 5 days before the election. And Bob Marley have second thoughts and start to ask the musician them, what you think about this? All the musicians say, boy, we don't want them, we never like it, and all the artists will decorate the place. Neville Garrick say, that never feel there, you know. And then can persuade Bob Marley to take out the heavy manners lyric out of the Smile Jamaica. Entrap them, entrap him, print the party colors, put the poster in the party colors, and give him party lyrics to sing about heavy manners. Well, fortunately, him pull out the heavy manners lyric out of it, but them still shot him. The two side make up and trap him, caught between the devil and the deep blue sea, or the deep orange sea, or the devil and the deep green sea. Good morning and welcome back to Straight Up. We're going to take your phone calls now, but we're just going to touch a little piece of Linton Kwesi Johnson, the forces of victory. Because all when them come well in 92 away and care. Along with several other people all over the island. I'm not talking about who labor to get detained. You know. All over the island they was scraping up people and putting people all kind of place. We the African freedom fighters, the forces of victory. From that time the black petty bourgeoisie. The black petty bourgeoisie have betrayed the population of Jamaica. Let's hear Linton Kwesi Johnson, the forces of victory.
Forward, nothing in the gate. Where the forces of victory
Yes, good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Hello, morning.
Morning, how are you doing?
Morning, Sir Jerry, how you do?
Fine, thank you.
Right, tried to call you from months ago, but couldn't get through.
Yeah.
Want to give my contribution concerning Pastor Harvey.
Yes, yes.
I realize he dominates every radio station this week.
Yes.
But why I want to talk to you, I realize you have maybe a little deeper understanding of some things.
Yeah.
Much more than some of the others that I listen to.
Yeah.
My take on it, and I stand corrected, I really don't believe that him should endorse a political party.
Yeah.
As a clergyman, because his role should be different.
Yeah.
And, you know, he shouldn't be a partisan person. He should be a person with the all Jamaican, whether you're Adventist, no matter, you know, who you are. If we look at the character in
yeah.
the Bible that became politician according to us, you can tell me how they reached that level. Like Joseph, if you look at Joseph, how he came to become governor, he really never put up himself or asked nobody to vote for him or anything like that.
Yeah.
Politician book and couldn't find the answer. Then he got to the church. Go to the man of God, really. Not the church, the man of God. Same thing with Daniel, you know.
No, they got to the prison. Or the prison. Put Joseph in prison. I prison him there. I prison him there, and them in a trouble, and them have to pull him out there for them find food.
That's what I'm saying.
No, he never in the church. He was in prison.
No, man, I know. I know that's a correct church. I say he was in prison.
Yeah, but you're going good, you know. You're going good.
Right. He was in prison, and the politician couldn't solve the problem.
Yes.
I find the answer to the problem, and then call him.
Yeah, no, they don't call him. He mean a detention. Them same one put him in a detention.
You know. Yeah, man, me know.
Yes, and when they're in a trouble, I have to go take him from out and fly the gate. Fly the gate and pull him out of the prison.
Right, right. And the same thing too with Daniel, too.
Yeah.
The king was in a calling politician, if you want him. You know, find himself in a position and then call him.
Yeah.
I am saying that I don't believe no Christian should, you know, offer themselves as representation.
No, no, hold on. Let's have a discussion now. Time for discussion. Now, I, on the other hand, believe that a Christian pastor free for running a seat. Now, that time him become a representative candidate. He's trying to represent the people in the area. Like what Paul Bogle did, and like what George William Gardner did, two of them are Christian pastors. You know? And if they want to represent the people, all the better if a pastor decides to come represent the people. More than enough. Would you allow me a little, please? Allow you for 2.5 minutes. Please let us have a discussion. I just want 1 minute and then you come back. So now, I believe a pastor have a right for running a seat. But he did not go to Halfway Tree as a candidate. He went there to bless the meeting as an Adventist pastor and as a person coming from the Adventist university and so on. Now, if he went there as a candidate and was kissed by a portion lineup, all the better for him, I think he would have a right there, so to know, so vote paint, but he didn't go there as a candidate like the Reverend Robinson some years ago, and many other pastors who have gone as candidates, right?
Yes, yes. I agree with you, but you see, I am looking from it from a different perspective, and I hear you sometimes allude to it. If you look at Jesus himself, you see, when he came, he never joined up with the Sanhedrin Council.
No,
no. None at all. He was an independent candidate in terms of justice to the people, whether you are Jew, Gentile, bondage.
He was a Nazarite.
Yes.
And he was also a man of the house of Judah. And mm-hmm. he had a special, and that's why he was allowed to speak inside the temple. And him quote Isaiah and him quote the Old Testament. He did have spiritual recognition. As a matter of fact, he was like a JP. Rabbi is like a JP, an authorized teacher. And when anybody commit a sin against the law in that time, and they are to be punished, they have to be authorized by a rabbi, somebody who know the law properly. And so it was that when they was going to kill Stephen, they went to Saul, a 24-year-old rabbi, a very young rabbi, and got his approval to stone Stephen. And they laid their clothes at Saul's feet. In other words, when you're going to stone somebody guilty of death, You have to go to a rabbi. I met the rabbi say, yes, this is the sentence, and he must be, and the person can be killed. And you have to take off your outer clothing, to allow yourself free, to throw the stone at them. That's why I take off the outer clothing and let this, the feet of the one who authorized, you know, the JP.
Yes. Yes,
I am telling you this. Hold on, we don't have no time for going further. Call me back again. But I'm telling you that both Jesus and Saul was rabbi, authorities in the law. They were rabbis, and that is why I was allowed to speak in the temple and quote scripture. I was a rabbi. Call again soon. The fact is this, that they was rabbis, and Saul himself was a rabbi, authorized to tell the people, them say, yes, would you allow me, please? I said, call back, and I will entertain you even 5 minutes. Call back. And as a matter of fact, that's how they tried to entrap Jesus when the woman was taken in adultery. They went to him as a rabbi so that he would say no. Them know that him have a compassionate heart. They were waiting for him to say, no, she must be stoned, so that they could stone him. Would you allow me, please? Anytime a rabbi except make a wrong judgment, he himself could be killed. So they wanted to entrap. They wanted to entrap Jesus and let him let go the woman so that they could have stoned him same time. And Jesus was so wise.
You're not a good trap, but we're not
no, you're time, still you know? Trying to override me because you realize that I'm pointing out the facts. And you want to override me?
Facts, so
no, call back again soon. You know, call back again soon and I give him 5 minutes. Call back right, soon.
Cool.
Because you will not be able to turn the law this way or that or the scripture.
No,
you won't. But I welcome you and I'm glad for you.
Alright, bless you.
Call again soon. I'll give you more time. Yes, sir. Matter of fact, I will allow you to participate in the debate. Thank you very much. I welcome you. Next call, please.
Morning.
Good morning. Welcome to Straight
Jerry.
Up. Yes, morning.
Aisha, you said you wanted some corrections. So
yes, ma'am.
Just let me call and do it.
Yes, ma'am.
Alright, just tonight is the 12 Tribe, Dennis Brown, Bob Marley dance selection.
Where?
At Skillcraft.
Then how I get a call yesterday that it is not tonight, it's tomorrow night.
Oh no.
Which one is?
Keep it on Fridays, you know. Anyway.
Hold on.
Mm-hmm. Confirm.
Hold on, please.
Yeah.
No, I said it's Friday because I heard it was Friday.
Me too.
Would you, just allow me, please, okay, I want the people in here. I said it was Friday because I heard it was Friday. I get a call from somebody very close to Skillcraft who is one of the music selector. Telling me say it's Saturday, then now you come and tell me it's Friday. And I don't doubt you, neither do I doubt the other person. Could you make another check and call me back, please, before the show done, please, ma'am?
Yeah, definitely will. And okay, and the Errol Douglas show,
yeah,
and Miss Kemp birthday show is tomorrow.
Yeah, that's what I said.
No, he said he wasn't sure if Errol Douglas was the
show. No, I said I was not sure if it's Errol Dunkley's birthday bash or is another
it's
artist.
Birthday.
Yes, so I did say it is tomorrow and
okay,
I did say that
right.
Because
okay.
I did... Hold on, please.
Mm-hmm.
I did say it's three major and worthwhile events on the same night, Saturday night. And that's why I said, but I wasn't sure whether it's Errol Dunkley, because I wrote it down, but I wasn't sure if it was that artist's birthday. But I thought so, and I'm pointing out that Palm Hall is one of the main...
Right.
Artist. Yes, ma'am. Thank you for going now, please.
No, Jerry, yes. And remember to say Bob Marley thing to the Bob Marley Museum is tomorrow.
Hold on, please. The Bob Marley thing, what is that?
The music that the Marleys have at the museum on the 6th.
No, hold on. The what that them, you're talking jumbling, okay? You talk fast. The what that the Marleys have?
The Bob Marley birthday thing at the museum on the 6th.
Oh, at Island House 56 Hope Road.
Yes.
So,
yes.
And it's during the day?
Yeah, they start early morning with the drumming, you know, with the Naya being drumming like about 6 o'clock.
Yes.
And go until probably about 9.
Well, I thank you for correcting me, and please just check it out one more time.
Yeah, I am.
Yes, please, yeah. And I myself am going to call back the other person and verify, please.
Okay.
Thank you very much, here, ma'am.
You're welcome.
No feeling away when we talk a little bit hard here, ma'am. Well, you know, so we don't have no hard feeling with you. She no answer. But you know. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Hello, morning.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yeah. I don't come to talk about that. Pastor Harvey must understand it is a time, it's a significant month between them. It is a time of the persecution of the Jews by the Christians, because there's nowhere in the Bible them can show you where Jesus ever said he was a Christian. And you must read in Bible and look at the religion that he's took out. The 7 days really a Christian, although my entire household was Christian. We were all Christian that 7 days, our mother was. What I call to talk to you about? Them say Professor Aldo taught us that capitalism and it, when it is go about to end, it's going to be
No, you're talking too fast. You're talking too fast. When it is about to what?
When it is about to finally the end of it completely, it will be more vicious than anything else. Now, Jamaicans must listen keenly to this argument about non-payment of taxes, God. There's a saying that says, pay your way, because there are those who are paying to enslave us. Watching the Democratic debate, there are two white men, the Koch brothers, who had viciously withheld billions, trillions of dollars of taxes to the federal government. Them say some of it is in the Bermuda and some of it is in the Cayman Islands. The Republican, or billionaire Republican, pays no taxes and this president is black skin. And use that non-payment of taxes to be viciously destroying the lives of blacks in America. 8,000 children have been poisoned in Missouri by the water.
Hold on a minute. Yes, now, the pastor who you say is getting persecuted there and all them people now, he is not a candidate like Reverend Robinson was an MP for PNP one time, and several pastors have been MPs and have been candidates. And in that context, they have every authority to endorse a party, but not as a person who has come to ask and was asked to come and bless a proceedings and bless a congregation or bless the crowd.
But religion was born out of politics, because all the great men recorded in the Bible, and the Bible is really a history book for me, they were participants in governance.
Hold on. You say that religion is born out of politics,
yes.
because that you're talking foolishness.
That's your opinion.
Thank you very much. All right, call back later.
Yeah, all right.
Let's go. Next one. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Morning, Jerry. How you doing?
Fine, thank you.
Jerry.
Yes, sir.
As far as I understand, Jamaica is operating on a tight fiscal policy.
Yeah.
Now, I'm not leaning one side or the other, but I heard Mr. Bowen saying what tax break you would give if he comes to power and all that. Is possible?
No, hold on. Tax break or no income tax? Which one?
Income tax.
No income tax.
Right.
So was it he who suggested that he would have a no income tax policy, or is it Shaw?
Andrew said last night that he would allow, I think it's $1.5 million to be tax-free of income tax.
$1.5 million salary per... Hold on. Salary per year.
Per year. Per year, yeah.
Yeah. What did Shaw say?
I think Shaw said he would start giving a tax break till he finally phases out.
Oh yeah. All right now. I can't speak authoritative on that, but one thing I know. It is not clear whether Shaw or Holness are speaking authoritatively about the economic policy of any possible GLP government. Not clear to me. Other people might know more, because you listen more than more me. I am not clear about whether Shaw or Holness is enunciating the economic policy. I can't tell.
This is confused to me about their outlook at it.
No, I don't even know if them consult. There's another person here, man, with it, Aubin Hill, who's supposed to be one of them economic thinkers, and they have another person running in East St. Andrew who seems to be quite authoritative on economics. What's your name again? Favour Williams. I'm not hearing anything
straight from them what their plans are.
All right, about the other side now. Tell me about the other side.
Well, they got their shortcomings. What I'm saying is this, I'd like to hear something straightforward on the economic outlook, the plan.
Who's on? Whose plans?
The alternative government.
Which is
the opposition.
But I just asked you, you fulsomely have expressed your opinion about the Labour Party side for about 2 minutes now. And then I ask you to give me opinion on the other side. And you said them have them shortcomings, they jump back to Labour. Why you don't tell me about the PNP side? Why you not tell me about?
We all see what they're doing. At least
we all see what they're doing, and at least what?
The citizens of Jamaica.
You said at least what?
At least we see what they're doing.
Yeah. And what?
With the fiscal policy.
No, and what? Tell me more about them. What coming out of my statement about them?
Well, they're getting on with the IMF program.
Yeah.
At least our debt GDP, our debt that income passes GDP has lowered.
Well, clearly you are endorsing them. So that is what you really came here to do, to endorse them as against the other. And that is fear. No, that is
back.
But that is your right, and that's perfectly fair. Perfectly fair. But you just wanted to be clear instead of you beating around the bush or hiding behind the bush.
We're called beating around the bush.
But you are welcome. You are welcome. Matter of fact, I want to invite you to participate in the debate here. Are you willing?
Yes, I am willing.
Yeah, so don't be shy. You don't have
I'm
to be
shy.
Well, you're kind of gun shy. All right, take your number. You can take your number off the air. Go and take your number off the air because you sound skillful like what?
Okay, good.
Yeah, thank you very much. We have any more calls? Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello?
Hey.
Welcome.
Roger?
Yes, sir.
Good morning.
Yes, sir.
All right, Christian, you bad gas report.
Yeah.
Supposed to eat your Mondagon, am I right?
I'm not sure, I think so.
Yeah, it's what's supposed to eat Mondagon for extension until after election. So don't everything done? Am I wrong or am I right? Am I barking up wrong to you or what? Am I seeing different?
No, your bark is, your bark might be worse than your bite. I don't know if you're barking up wrong to you.
All right, no. Well, me know everything done for you or November, October, you start until January.
What start?
The bad gas thing.
I start from before that.
All right.
I have two cars where I licked by the bad gas from in 2014. And then park right now. Two cars I have parked now where bad gas licked them.
All right, listen on.
What me sell it a while?
Huh?
What me sell? And I fix them doing? I fix them, you know. But I park them still. But it's bad gas that lick them.
Yeah,
I will send go far and go buy 6 or 8 injector for one.
You?
For one.
Yeah.
Pure gum, then gum up.
Right,
from 2014.
Right, 14, yeah. 15, 16. All right.
Yeah, not 2 years. Like one year and a half.
I always tell you, same the money that him get paid on 6 week thing.
Yeah.
Spend off I want every parish to get a vehicle. But I would suggest to him...
To get a vehicle to do what?
Yeah, every parish to get a vehicle that can park out the place. I do whatever.
You mean to get a vehicle that going go around and counteract the mosquito? They enough to talk here, Mr. Kuhn.
All right, thank you. But what I would suggest, it's cheaper if I have some vehicle and spread the money, stretch the money.
Yeah.
You have to pay a driver.
Look here, only have 20 seconds more. Go ahead.
Yeah, you have to pay a driver and a vehicle, but it's cheaper.
Yeah.
In my vehicle, we do the work.
All right.
All right, one love.
And your driver's license up to date?
No, but we can't drive again. All right,
you're tight. Good morning, welcome to Straight Up, hello?
Jerry.
Yes, ma'am.
All right, I spoke with someone who actually knows everything that's going on with the skin crossing.
Yeah.
Okay, so it was an error that was sent out that has been corrected. So we weren't wrong because we saw what we saw. So it's actually tomorrow, the 6th at Skillcraft. What I think they had was Friday the 6th.
Oh, yes, yes.
Saturday the 6th.
Yes, yes. A good thing on a Friday 13th, otherwise people will say about a bad luck. So it's tomorrow night, Aisha?
Yes.
Saturday the 6th. Lot of things going on.
And I tell you, she's a daughter of Pinky Dan. She having something tonight at Burlington.
Hold on. Italy?
Yeah, the daughter of Pinky Dan. Our father,
Pinky.
And Dan Vision.
Hold on, the man. Not Dan Vision. Pinky. Yeah, Pinky from upper common.
Yes, her daughter.
Pinky from Pomona Common.
Yes.
And Dan Visionaire's daughter.
Right.
That's Spree daughter, Mr. Watson.
Right.
And daughter named Italy. And yes. She a keeper?
She having an event tonight at Burlington Avenue, 8 Burlington Avenue.
That is Nanook?
No, it's the place in Reggae Hostel.
Okay. What number Burlington?
8 Burlington Avenue off Eastwood Park.
Yes, man. Same place, same road where Nanook de Pondo.
Right.
All right. Thank you very much. Yes. You are so helpful.
Okay. Listen.
But you know that.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
All right. Well,
yes, ma'am. All right. That is great information. It is tomorrow night for Skillcraft. It is tomorrow night for Miss Kemp's birthday bash. And it is tomorrow night for Mr. Dunkley birthday bash at Ronnie Williams Theatre, which will be starred by Pam Hall and Dunkley. Next call. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Good morning, Jerry.
Morning, ma'am.
Yes. Let me preface what I have to say by saying this. I believe in agreeableness.
Agreeableness.
Yes. And I believe that we can agree to disagree.
Yes.
So if you disagree with something I say.
Yes.
let us agree that we disagree. We don't have to, like, you know.
You mean agree to disagree peacefully?
Right.
Okay.
Good. Because you know, I respect you highly.
Then what that have to do with disagreement and not peacefully? Would
I
you?
Get nervous when I myself get nervous when, you know, this kind of disagreeableness come up.
So when has this disagreeable come up? When?
All right.
when it come up?
No. You know why God didn't destroy Satan immediately? Because we know that the other angels looking on would get frightened.
then how me get involved in that now?
All right, Jerry, let's put that aside. The point I want to make...
I don't want to put it aside before we're done with it. If it's nice, don't just put it aside. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Don't fix it till it broke.
All right. I like how you're sounding. I like how you're sounding.
I love how you sound.
Oh, thank you.
Don't tell me, man. Thank the Lord I am giving that tone.
Yes, amen. Amen.
Go ahead, ma'am.
First point I want to make. The gentleman was giving reference to Joseph and Daniel.
Yes, ma'am.
Joseph and Daniel were not living in their own land.
Yes, yes.
Right?
Yes.
We live in, if we own this land, then we must stand up for it like David.
You mean we the inhabitants of Jamaica?
Yes.
Do we own this land?
That's what I said. He even said if.
I'm asking you now.
I really don't think we own it as we ought to.
Oh, we are owed it.
Right.
Own and owed come from the same source, you know.
Right.
But there's a difference.
You know, I endorse reparations.
Yes, ma'am.
So, if we really own this land, we should stand up for it like David.
Yeah.
Against all the Goliaths.
Yes, yes.
And I think that you're like a David, stand up against all the Goliaths. And I'm not a person to flatter people.
No.
Right? If something is true, it is just true.
Yeah.
And I can't hide my conscience. Right?
Yes.
I think you're doing right in outlining the real history of the country. You know?
Yeah, others are doing it too. Well, it's the only job in town. It's the only game in town.
Yeah. And I get my sense of right from what I see in the scriptures.
Yes, yes.
And the first five books of the Bible is scattered over there. God reminded
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
We're out of time. 10 o'clock news. May I take a number of there? Because we want at least 2 more minutes with you.
All right.
What may I tell you? Yes, good morning and welcome back to Straight Up. We're into the second hour of the program. We expect a couple of visitors here who will tell us about Reggae Month activities and Bob Marley, both of them very authoritative. Herbie Miller among them. And we have an interview by Judy Mott. An interview by Judy Mott, but I don't edit it because it's about an hour long and we can only run about half an hour at a time. I might run 2 days straight. But I didn't get to edit it enough to play it today. Because I wanted to play before Bob Marley's birthday. But you can't play after his birthday. This one is so special. Interview with Judy Mott, her experiences with Bob Marley, music industry, and other things. Very special interview with Judy Mott. So now, anyway, before I look at the paper, I just ran outside a while ago and I take a little glance at the paper. And before I look at it, I already wrote down a note to make a comment. Very similar to the headline that I see about KD Knight wanting to keep Malawu Fort in the Senate. In other words, make sure don't win a seat and therefore she have to go back to the Senate. What I wrote down from last night that Mr. Atkins, now is the Attorney General. Is he slated to go into the Senate? Does the PNP plan to put him in the Senate, like how them pull him out of the seat in the House of Representatives? Do they plan to put him in the Senate or keep him as Attorney General? Or is it done with him? Why them really want to pull him out of the seat? Done with him as Attorney General. You don't have to have a seat to be Attorney General, you know. But you have to be in the Parliament because I'm a member of the Cabinet. So you have to be either in the House of Representatives or in the Senate. And if them pull him from being a candidate, they would have to put him in the Senate for him to continue as Attorney General. Is it that them want to get rid of Atkinson? Or are they going to put him in the Senate? Very similar to the idea of KD Knight wanting to confine Malawu Fort to the Senate. And then we're going to play a few pieces of music because the lady, we're going to talk with her more. She's very interesting. She's on the line waiting. I'm going to play a little piece of music by Monty Morris. Just play it cool because she's telling us, just play it cool. Let us agree to disagree peacefully and not disagree bitterly. Monty Morris, a little medley by Monty Morris. First piece is Just Play It Cool. Let's hear it, please.
You will never get no beer. Just play it cool. Stick by the rule. Don't play the fool. If you did love him so, why did you hurt him so? And then you let him go after you hurt him so. Tell me why. Just play it cool, stick by the rules, don't play the fool.
Yes, that's a little piece of Rocksteady by Monty Morris. Because you know the transition was treated in different ways by different people. Scatter Rocksteady just for about a 9 month or so. And then reggae. The Wailers themselves say, boy, Rocksteady start playing some kind of Rasta beat. But them still a rock it steady. Well, Monty Morris next now. Mama no fret. Because you know all the people fretting are going. And Monty Morris I tell him all the don't fret. Mama no fret. Me go hear peace out.
Mama no fret, Papa no fret, Mama cry no tears for me. If he is with you, they can be against you. Fret not yourself over me. What is to be, it must be. No matter what they say or do, after a storm there must be a calm. Fret not yourself over me. If you know how I love you, you wouldn't cry a tear for me. Because you love me, you would cry a river for me. Mama no fret, Papa no fret, Mama cry no tears for me. If he is with you, they can be against you. Fret not yourself over me. Mm-hmm.
man no fret.
Yeah, no fret, mama. Because those, you know, if he is with you, who can be against you? Then know him talk to mommy and daddy one time, one at a time, you know. Because them want to come put pressure upon the family and the community. And Monty Morris said, mama and papa, they want a piece of me. A long time them phrased about, you know. Long time, you know. This is from 1962. They want a piece of me. But me and my 45. You're Monty Morris. Me and my 45, mommy and daddy. Listen him good. Yes, me and my 45, Monty Morris. That's from about late 61, 62, you know. Early ska. Drum be a go. Well, let's get back to the phone. We have Herbie Miller in the house. God, thank God for that. And let's get back to the phone. Good morning, ma'am.
Yes, Jerry.
Yes, ma'am.
I like the song, Let's Play It Cool.
Yes,
I like
ma'am.
That one.
I play it with you in mind.
All right, give thanks. So as I was saying, the Bible tells us that the elders must always teach the youngsters, you know, tell them where we're coming from, how we got over, right?
Yes.
So that, you know, when they see us doing certain practices, they are aware of the genesis of it.
Yes, ma'am, not to mention the Exodus.
Yeah, right? Right? Well, that was what I was basically said, but I wanted to put one more thing in the pot. Did you know? Well, I've seen it on the internet, I researched it, that the Queen of England has black blood in her.
You mean she have African blood in her?
Yeah.
I don't doubt that, because all human beings originated in Africa.
It's not a matter of originating in Africa. She had a Moorish ancestor.
Hold on there. One step at a time. The first step is this, that all human beings originate in Africa and spread out. And it's after them spread out, their physical characteristics start to differentiate.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah.
They got white. They got white and they got angular eyes and they got different features after leaving Africa.
Mm-hmm. But this one is that there's a black Moorish person who is in her line.
Yes, I believe.
The Moors were those who taught the Europeans civilization.
No. There was civilization before the Moors, but the Moors brought them more up to date. And the Moors taught them navigation. And the Moors taught them navigation by the stars. They taught them that the earth was round like a ball and not round like a plate. Because they thought it was round like a plate. The edge of which it would drop off if you go too far. But we the Moors taught them is round like a ball, not like a plate. And many other things. But they did have a civilization before.
I found it very amusing when I heard it. It was just a sister was saying it to me, finding me that the queen was black. Because, you know,
no, she's not black. No, she's not black.
You have a tube of black in there, black.
No. The queen is not black. She has some African blood in her, quite likely. Now, hear this. From when I was a young little youth, I get to find that when people say, him go on like him white and him no white. As if white is better than black. So from your young youth, me developed the thought that if they think that they are white, give them that, they're not getting a bonus, it's nothing better than nothing. You are white, from you think you're white, me just have you as white, you know. Because no better than nothing, anything at all. So, I agree
I
with you that...
I know they detest black, so...
Who? Hold on, ma'am. Hello, ma'am. 1 minute, please.
Running in their veins.
1 minute, please.
That is very amusing.
1 minute, please. Who is the they that detest blacks?
Eh?
Who is the they that detest blacks?
The whites who are racist.
It's not all whites detect black, detest black, ma'am. And it's not all blacks who are good either.
Right.
It's not all. There's no one brush to paint people with.
Exactly. I agree completely.
Thank you very much, yeah, ma'am.
But you know that our black people have suffered. We are suffering from this whatever it is, coming from the whites, that we are inferior.
I don't suffer from any such thing.
Neither me.
They know you say we. They know you say we.
Neither me. But when I look around and see the youngsters.
Yeah. But hear this.
I see a youngster in my class.
Hello, ma'am.
And he's so pretty and nice and good.
Hello, ma'am.
One day I saw
hello, 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 hello.
I was so disappointed.
Hello, ma'am. I want you listening, because if we're not listening to one another, we're not going to pay attention to one another. We're kind of gone over the time, but the youngsters are no worse than the oldsters, ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
But call again regular. I think you're worthwhile if you hear from your regular.
All right.
Thank you very much, dear ma'am. We have one of that. We have two more. Because we're going to come to Herbie Miller. All right, let's hear Margarita, because Herbie Miller is telling us what the museum is doing. The Institute of Jamaica and the Music Museum, Jamaica Music Museum, 5th Annual Groundation. Groundation is a series that they have every year. And it will be 4 Sundays straight. And the first one will be Ongo Mamu Malungoma, Musings on Don Drummond. And he will expand on that. Let's hear that music from Margarita, Woman A Come, singing about her man and when he's in his solitude and all different kind of thing about her man, her superior understanding.
Ayata, your daughter, from Venturian border, A Come. Sound, Ongo Malungo Man, Ongo outer space. Ungo malungo ma. True melody of my beautiful. Monaco.
This is a warning, woman a come. Jennifer, find that for me, not Jennifer. Warning by Jennifer. Piece of music name, warning by Jennifer. But Margarita was warning about that from 1963. Welcome to the studio, Herbie Miller, which you occupy on our Sunday.
On a Sunday.
Yes, man.
Yes,
name of your program again.
Well, Clinton Hutton and I host Links,
yeah,
from 11 to 2 in the afternoons on Sunday. And from 9 to 11, I do something called Jazz Nocturnal.
9 to 11, which day?
Sundays.
Sunday, yeah, in the evening.
In the evening, yeah, man.
Yeah, man. And so it is. Now, you've been hosting a series for years now. The groundation, and the inspiration of it is the assembly of Rastafari, reasoning and music and all kind of different things.
Ritual.
That's traditional all around the island, but especially in the east, west, north and south. Especially in the hills of Warrica, groundation. And count as the album.
Groundation.
Yeah, you have one name, groundation. It's different from the triple album.
The triple album is the classic album.
Yeah.
Groundation with, yeah, the mystic revelation of Rastafari.
No, you're focusing now on the mystique of Don Juan, especially as enunciated by Margarita.
Yes.
Tell us about this four Sunday series in February.
Well, on Sunday the 7th, which is the after tomorrow, I will do a presentation entitled Margarita and Malungo, the victory and sorrows of an art couple. And of course, both Drummond and Margarita were a couple, and predating, say, Bob and Rita, or Alan and Judy, who I consider also art couples, or like Cicely Tyson and Miles Davis, or Abby Lincoln and Max Roach, or even Diego Rivera and Frida Kahlo, closer to Don Drummond in terms of how they created art and their intellectual balance. So we want to look at Drummond in that relationship musically and otherwise. The following Sunday the 14th, we'll have Don Drummond as viewed by poets. And poets will include the poet laureate Mervyn Morris, internationally acclaimed poets Kwame Dawes and Lorna Goodison, along with Raymond Mayer, and of course Jerry Small, Bongo Jerry, all of whom have written poems on Don Drummond, inspired by Don Drummond, and reflecting the personality, musically and otherwise, of Don Drummond. Then on the 21st, we assemble a group of international trombonists beginning with Delphia Marcellus. Then we have Andre Merkinson. He's a young trombonist, considered the most brilliant of his generation. Of course, with Marcellus, you don't doubt brilliance and musicality, in other words, otherwise. And then there's Steve Touré, the man considered the greatest living jazz trombonist today. Now, none of these people need drumming to validate themselves, and yet they align themselves so much to drumming that we want to know what it is about drumming and his music and his personality that has been so endearing to people like Delphia Marcellus and Steve Touré. At the same time, we'll have local trombonists. We're featuring the trombonists on this one to help us decipher the musical brilliance, if that's what it is, of Don Drummond. And come the 28th, the final week, we will have Professor Freddie Hicklin, a psychiatrist, noted psychiatrist. We'll have Dr. Earl McKenzie, a philosopher who has written on Drummond, who has taken on both Jerry and I in terms of our view of Drummond in a scholarly way. And also we'll have our friend Dr. Clinton Hutton, a supreme cultural theorist, to talk about Drummond and his schizophrenia, his genius, his madness. So these four Sundays draw on individuals who have paid a lot of attention to Don Drummond. And so, you know, between art and intellectualism, we wish at the end of it to have visitors understand more about Drummond. But Jerry and people, I must...
Well, for wind up. Make it wait till you come back from the break, please.
Sure, of course.
All right, because Herb is here to welcome you to come. The only reason I'm come here is they wanted to come to the Institute of Jamaica every Sunday this month at 2 o'clock, and I tell it worth a while. I'm postponing that trip to the country. Yeah, there's a series at the Institute of Jamaica put on by the Jamaica Music Museum. And for years it's been going on now, Groundation, which is mostly reminiscent of the way our Rastafari and other revivals of African culture usually gather and reason, sometime overnight, through the day and overnight, accompanied by music, food and different things. And the reason why Groundation is used is because usually there are some professional musicians and the contemporaries of whoever is being discussed, sometimes the people themselves being discussed, who come to the Institute of Jamaica and subject ourselves to a Groundation. Now, I'm going to play a piece of music that demonstrate what the kind of interpretation that Drummond was capable of. Because this piece of music is a tribute to a musician, a tribute to an instrument, but not Drummond's instrument, and yet Drummond is used to demonstrate the mightiness of this tribute. The music named The Mighty Organ, singing about an instrument, the organ, and the great organist and the mighty organ, and yet his Drummond interpreted. Let's hear The Mighty Organ by Lascelles Perkins, way, way back.
Yesterday, when the mind day I place this ring upon your finger will forever linger in my memory.
Yeah man, the same musician, them same bass and drum and thing we play Tell Me Darling. And I think at the same studio too. But yes, Herbie. So tomorrow that will be that.
Sunday.
Yeah, Sunday that will be that.
Yes.
Stress upon Sunday more than the subsequent weeks I'm no more.
Okay. Well, also on Sunday we begin with the launch of Heather Augustine's book on drumming.
Where's she from?
Heather is American.
African-American?
Not African-American at all.
Which kind of American?
Caucasian-American, white-American. But she has, in the last 4 or 5 years, dedicated her focus to Jamaican music, in particular ska music and ska musicians.
Mm.
And so her book, Don Drummond, the World's Greatest Trombone Player, will also be launched on Sunday.
All right. I want to tell about the sponsor, but do you remember Miss Goodman?
No.
Young Miss Goodman, her father was a prominent architect in Jamaica. I think his name Marvin Goodman.
I remember his name.
And his daughter, a young Jewish lady, was doing a lot of work on Drummond and Margarita. She started a book. But I just wondering if you know. All right. No. Who are the sponsors for this thing?
We have JMMB, and we're so thankful for them for joining us this year. Irie FM, of course, News Talk 93. Chase Funds really helped us out this year, and we appreciate that. Linstead Market, Jerry, as you know, they're always there, and we appreciate Norman and his company for doing that. And this year, for the first time, CPTC will also be covering the whole thing and making it available for...
In other words, they're going to record...
Yes.
On video.
On video.
Make it available to...
To public TV.
Oh.
So we can, those of us who aren't able to make it, and we'll have it for posterity in the library.
No,
well.
At the funeral of Miss Wilmot, Cynthia Wilmot, a great associate at Don Drummond, Carlos Malcolm and many more, along with her husband Fred Wilmot. The family made available several videos of plays, documentaries and different things that Cynthia did over the year. At very reasonable prices. Are we going to get available some of these records of the Jamaica Music Museum, like what you got at Cynthia Wilmot funeral?
You mean the things that we have recorded?
Yeah. Other recordings that have been deposited with you.
With the Music Museum. As you know, Jerry, we are growing. And the big picture is that we should have a research library so that this sort of information is indeed available to everyone who wishes to research our great music and culture. And so the answer is yes. At present, we have documented quite a bit of our activities. However, we don't have the facilities nor the resources to make them commercially available at this time. But on special request, you know, there have been researchers who want to know certain things, and we do our best to facilitate those requests.
Yeah, man, that's great. All right. Well, thank you very much for having been here. And again, Groundation is a series at the Jamaica Music Museum in concert to the Jamaica, in the Institute of Jamaica, and the sponsor that Herbie mentioned, put on every year, for years now, 5 years now.
This is our fifth.
Groundation.
And by
Sunday 2 o'clock.
By the way, out of this one, we'll do a book compilation that will capture the best, well, not the best, we'll capture what we can of the first five
That's
years.
Great, that's great.
Jerry, give thanks.
Yeah, man, and we are in a political season now. Going to play a piece of music that was a dread. It was a dread of the Jamaica Labour Party government between 1963 and 1972 when Michael Manley put them out of their misery. It was a dread of them. Carry go, bring come. Justin Hines, Don Drummond, and Wolf of them.
Bring me three.
Yes, as I said, that was a dread of the Jamaica Labour Party government between 1963 and 1972, and a matter of fact, as I've told you several times on this program, at the closing session of the parliament, the closing session in 1972 February, David Coore making his last statement in the 67 to 72 parliament, his last statement, he quoted not only the Bible but just the nines and the dominoes. How long shall the wicked reign over my people? And it looked long, because it's 40 a year from that, and the two wicked them still are reign over the people. Because they never put them there to reign. They were not created to reign, they were created to serve, but then come to reign. And I tell you, it applies now. Carry go, bring come. Let's go for matter of fact, although I did point out that Cynthia Wilmot and Fred Wilmot were close associates of Carlos Malcolm. Carlos Malcolm actually used to live out of them place, out of Bulby there, and then New Drummond. The fact is that several trained musicians, including Sonny Bradshaw and others, tried to put down Drummond. They were a little bit jealous of the acclaim that he received. Tried to put down Drummond as not being that good. And it is true that Fred Wilmot himself, he kind of put down Drummond, but kind of put Drummond in any place. But Drummond cannot be put in any place. Let's go for a break, straight up. And we have another artist in the studio. This month is Reggae Month. And we're going to talk with an artist in the studio. I think we had communication with him before, but I just keep a couple of people here. I want to... couple of people here already want to yell. Where are they? They are where? Yes, Miss Marcia Brown. She's a security at Jamaica National in Alphatree. Marcia Brown, the lady who don't need no makeup at all. You see her yesterday morning, yesterday afternoon. Also, Mr. Trout from Passage Fort. I hear that Mr. Trout is a faithful listener of News Talk, not just straight up, but News Talk 93. Mr. Trout, he's unsighted, you know. He's unsighted, is what people call a blind person, but Mr. Trout listen to the station here faithfully and listen to straight up. Mr. Trout of Passage Fort. And as I said, Miss Marcia Brown, security at Jamaica National Infantry. Also, Stacy and... what is her name again? Mace or Massa? I can't remember the last name. I think it's Mace or Massey. But she's at Hilo in Halfway Tree. Stacy Ann at Hilo in Halfway Tree. We want her to visit the studio one day. Very interested in listening off straight up. There are some more, but I don't... I can't differentiate them here now. But let's get back to my brethren. What's going on, sir?
Give thanks.
You have a new You have a new release, culture-wise, otherwise known as ILEI. And this release is Sound Advice, or is a different one?
No, Roots and Peanut.
Oh, Roots and Peanut. So, what's happening? When next are you going to be performing?
Yeah, well, I have forward in New York this Sunday.
Yeah.
And by next Saturday, I'm going to perform forward, you know?
Yeah? You're performing, New York Saturday?
Sunday. Oh, you're about Sunday.
And after that, where?
I'll be performing at Merrick Boulevard. Going by a place named Lana's, you know?
Merrick Boulevard, where's that?
Boulevard, that's in Queens, you know?
Oh, Queens in New York, oh.
Naturally.
Okay. At that place name, bro?
In Lana's.
Lana's. Yeah, so you spend most time where? Jamaica or where?
No, I spent most time in New York for the last 6 years, you know?
Yeah. So they use the, what Roots and Peanut now is about, advice about?
About the roots them, that you sip up and thing and the peanut you blim up and thing, you know?
Yeah.
So it's a combination of roots and peanut.
We're going to listen it, but which part you recorded?
I recorded it in New York, but Chuck Buck Rhythm, Chuck Buck Production.
Oh, so you recorded on a rhythm?
Sent forward.
That exists already, okay.
No, I think I'm the first person on that rhythm, you know?
All right. So which part of Jamaica you did rise up?
Rise up from Lindsay, you know, born at a couple of places named Amwalk, 13 miles.
You remind me.
Naturally. He's a Lindsay man.
Yeah, like Joseph Hill and culture.
Definitely. I come from Alcazar, you know?
Alcazar.
Yeah, in the same region.
Boy, I love that drive there to go through Alcazar. Go up in the hill.
Yeah, man.
The back of the hill.
Above rocks and them place there, you know?
Yeah, man. Glengarve, all them.
Yes, I, for real.
Alcazar.
One
nice bridge over the river there. And
naturally, you know?
I love them places.
Yeah, you know the thing, man.
Yeah, man. I love that place.
I see.
Now go here now. Roots and Peanut or Peanut and Roots?
Roots and Peanut.
Yes.
A culture wise, I mean, say Ireland and get lively. That one is a Chuck Buck production. I get the girl them heat up. See, ya, it's like sipping up some roots and then me blending up some peanut. Two leaf of aloe vera, get me body clean up. Stamina fit and here, can't say me lean up. Sipping up some roots and then me blending up some peanut. Two leaf of aloe vera, get me body clean up. Stamina fit and here, can't say me lean up. Sipping up some roots and then me blending up some peanut. Two leaf of aloe vera, get me body clean up. What leaf a girl from across the world just a call me phone up to them a ball. How much them want for yuck me up? Me can't stall under me roots with me peanut. Them up one and all of them a tip like a the sky. Them want for touch a roots man a sip down with some peanut. Them up fi straighten up me back and me no want it bend up. And the girls them never vex, we always friend up. Them a be linky so them link me over me yard them pen up. It's like sipping up some roots and then me blending up some peanut. Two leaf a aloe vera, get me body clean up. Stamina fit and here, can't say me lean up. Sipping up some roots and then me blending up some peanut. Two leaf of aloe vera, get me body clean up. Stamina fit and here, can't say me lean up. Sipping up some roots and then me blending up some peanut.
So in New York, when you go perform now, it's tracks, you go perform to tracks?
Tracks and bands.
Yeah?
It all depends on the promoter, the promotion of the show, you know?
Oh, so usually you perform inside a dance or strictly a...
Perform inside our club, perform on outdoor shows, you know?
Yeah.
Like in the summertime, I do all the big shows in the park in the Queens, you know, like Groove in the Park, Irish Jamboree Festival, Rockabessa, all them shows there, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, man, I want a top performer up in New York there, you know? And even Jamaica in the show I touch, you know? And I is a great performer, you know? When the world can check out my thing on YouTube and can see the performance.
So where the last place to perform?
Ninja Man, no, first night I was at Portmore. Yeah. I think them Jungle Fire.
Okay. And what's about Ninja Man?
Yeah, I was at Ninja Man Birth Night Bash also, you know?
Alright. So when you start, after you left school, you go to school in Linsett?
No, I go to school in a couple places named Amwalk, that's my birthplace, you know?
Okay.
All your school.
How you get involved in that music?
Well, see, for me, I look at you, my stepfather's have a change on the other play all the time, you know? The music, I'm sitting there listening to some Ken Booth, some John Holt, Eptones, all these things, you know?
Yeah.
So, in the bed earlier morning time, nothing treat me like the music, you know?
Yeah.
One of my cousins used to sing with a group named, before them come to the meditation, at Anthony Collins.
Oh, yeah.
My cousin used to sing with them and things, so when him come down the music vibe, and I used to just rub on to I and I see him, you know?
Yeah.
So, we go up and things.
All right, anytime you do anything, you keep in touch with us, here, sir?
That's a must, you know?
Well, thank you very much for having me.
And it's a pleasure to you, know?
Yes,
up. King.
Yes, sir.
I just want you to fill a couple of people up under the Lindsay City and things. You like herb, I don't know my spice, man. I ain't cook my food every day, you know? My mother knew you, I can't tip her, my first girl. Love you, yeah, mom? Art.
And as I said, we have a lovely interview with Sister Judy Mott, but I wasn't able to edit it in time. I don't want to play it unedited. So next week, most likely, we're going to split it in two and play it in two parts. It could be in one part, but most likely in two parts. That's Judy Mott talking about Bob Marley, her experiences with you know, working with him and other experiences of Judy Mott. We're going to take the last two calls. We have three here. We're going to take the last two numbers because we might only have, we only have time to take one before the 11 o'clock news. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Good morning, Jerry.
Go ahead.
I hear you on the court this morning, man, but I have to ask you some questions. I'm not going to say how hard or good you are. Tell me something. When them whole gunshot did come from Cuba, who did that rule?
Them whole lipa gunshot did come from Cuba. What year? What year?
In 1970.
What year?
Year. I can't recall the year, but in 1970.
No, well, if you can't recall the year, we cannot address what you're talking about.
All right. Another thing again. Tell me something. Those wrong things was going on. Your brother, they were in the politics at that time.
What my brother name?
Yusumal.
And if he was in the politics, when which wrong things was going on?
When the whole for dirtiness of the PMP didn't be that carry on.
Name the dirtiness. Name the incidents. Name the incident. Green Bay. Yes. Yes, he was in the parliament. Hold on. Hold on. You're not going bullet on this thing. You're going to answer them one. Green Bay. Yes, he was there and he was in the cabinet.
All right. And number one again. The island, the road.
Which island, which road?
Younger St. Elizabeth, when the PNP keep me now.
What year?
In the 70s.
What year?
In the 70s.
Disqualified. Another question. Next one.
All right. Now tell me something. Tell me the only thing you can tell me now. When Sierra coming back on Garvey body, them never like that because from the birth of the PNP, they never like to see nothing good that JLP do. The last thing that JLP do that is good, we will get everything like full for Farry. Stop now.
All right, cut him. I'm not going to bully this. Cut that. Next call, please. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up. Back where with your bullies. You carry that to Siaga. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Morning.
Welcome.
I have a few pointers I want to make about this program.
Go ahead.
Yes. I think you need to go and study the art of journalism. Study the art of journalism since you claim to be a guru on political science.
I, Jerry Small, claim to be a guru on political science?
Yes.
When did I claim that?
Listen to me, by your words. You need to be balanced.
You are making statements that are false. I have never claimed to be a guru on political science. I've wasted my time. Back away out there, right now. Out of you're a waste of time. Next one. Good morning. All right, let's go to the 10 a.m. headline news. It's a waste of time. I've wasted that telephone call. I have never claimed to be a guru on political science. Back away. We're not going to tolerate any this time. We're going to allow you. And as you start with your falsehood, we'll make you go away with your falsehood. And the last caller said I gave him some time because another idiot was wasting the time. An idiot does not mean fool. Another idiot was wasting the time and I decided to let in another caller. He wasted it also. Here I'm wasting. He said that him going to give me some pointers about the program. Now I gladly accept any pointers about the program. And then him proceed to say that I claim to be a guru on political science. So I said, all right, we're going to interrogate the idea. I asked him, when did I claim or have I ever claimed to be a guru on political science? He cannot state so, and he's trying to sidestep it and go on to make his points, saying that I must study journalism and all kind of thing. I still needed to know from him, when did I claim to be a guru in political science? He cannot state any such thing. I've never made any such claim. What claims has anybody ever heard me make? Tell me what claim you never hear me make. About anything, including history. So now I'm going to play this piece of music. I decided to play from last night. I have nothing to do with him, but it's still applicable to him. It's applicable to me also. It is applicable to me also. A name, Practice Where You Preach. Barry White. You tell me this or you tell me that and all kind of horse dead and cow fat. Straight up.
So, what do you want to do? I'm here, baby. I'm ready, baby. I'm waiting on you. Believe me, I am patiently waiting on you. Yeah, there's something wrong with me. Every time I'm alone with you, you keep talking about you loving me. Hey, baby, your foreplay just blows my mind. So why don't we stop all the talking, girl? Why don't we stop wasting time? I've had my share of lovers, some say I'm damn good. And if you think you can turn me out, baby, I wish that you would, cause you keep telling me this and telling me that. You say once I'm with you, I'll never go back. You say there's a lesson that you wanna teach. Well, here I am, baby, practice. Just you and me. So many things I can do to you, and so many ways I can please. Hey, 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 it's your move, yeah. Why don't you start turning down the lights and show me just what you can do? Hey, baby, I've had my share of lovers, some of them were damn good. But if you think you can turn me out, girl, I just wish that you would, cause you keep, oh, you just keep, now you just keep telling me this and telling me that. You say what's wrong with you, I'll never go back. See, there's a lesson you wanna teach. Here I am, baby, practice what you preach.
Because it's a fact,
is it?
Once I've been with you, you'll never go back.
Really?
There is a lesson.
All right, let's get back to the practice. Let's get back to the practice of what we preach. Morning, welcome straight up, hello?
Hello?
Yes, welcome.
Yeah, morning, Jerry.
Morning, sir.
It's a first time caller, you know?
Thank you very much.
Yeah, man, I can't find our place named Plowden, yeah.
Plowden? Oh, yeah, sir.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. But I'm going to tell you, Jerry.
Yeah.
I'm going to come off the radio, man. I'm going to tell you, say, I'm going to come off a new staff, you know, sir.
Ah, Joe?
Yeah, man, I'm going to tell you, man. I hear you bring up a thing this morning about the political history of Jamaica. Well, not really. Some part of the history still. You were talking about Claude Matop and Jim Brown and all them, man.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, man, because my band 64 is telling me about your little idea of coming up to the 80s still.
Yes, right? Man, yes, man.
I'm not telling you, boy, you're in let me, man. You're in let me a lot, you know?
You must test it, you know? Don't swallow what I give you. Test it.
Yeah. Yeah, man, so, boy, I'm telling you, man, I enjoy the program and everything, you know? I'm not required to be taking it. Now, I'm not required not. I'm not telling you, I want radio, you know?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man, quiet on my family.
Yeah, the thing is, starting about the IMF.
Yeah.
Most of the time, especially in this campaign season.
Yeah.
Why you tell me what the significance of the IMF and how it origin, how it started and what it does for Jamaica? Because in the JP, then the past not test them so far.
Yeah.
And then been passing at the test. So I want to know if that is a benefit to Jamaica and what it does. And
no, I don't. All right, just in a few seconds. I don't think them said that the JLP never passed any test. I think them said that them never passed no test in the 4 years recently.
Right.
IMF is a international grouping of bankers and money men. that form up after the war, the Second World War. Yes. And what they do, they control money that people need and nations need. Yes. And they set the conditions upon which people get these money. And what right. they do, they dictate the conditions that make it easy for themselves and them businesses to come into your country and get all of the best terms possible, otherwise I'm not lending the money. So them soften you up for coming, and them keep wages low, and them back the policy that say people not have land, because when people have land, them now come and work for $5,600 a week.
Okay.
I have to go. All right, one more, go on.
All right, we go on. Taking the program. So why you slapping so much on MS thing there, and basically, you know, inform me. Yeah.
But you must listen to many other people. Don't listen to me alone and test anything that I tell you.
All right, respect that, Jerry.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, man. See you,
next
man.
One, please. Good morning. Welcome. Straight up, hello.
Yeah, good morning.
Go ahead.
Good morning, my brother. Good morning to all my brothers and my sisters. Jerry, what's up? Jerry, you tell me that I mustn't call. Why I mustn't call, Jerry? Anyway, Jerry. May I tell it, say, Jerry? Yeah, you know, I'm not from that talk to you, and you're not answer me. Mr. Dean, big up yourself. Joseph, Ms. Lana, Marlon, Madanjo, Andrea, Paul, Kiba, Daniel. Yeah, man, I'm just going to bless you for yourself, for all the rest of my brothers and sisters, them, because I cannot talk to somebody and they not talk to me. Love you, no. Bye. Bye, Jerry. Love you too, still.
Boom, bye. Next one, please.
Jerry.
Morning.
Good evening. Good afternoon. Good morning, yeah.
How are you doing?
Not bad. Yeah, man, I mean, I enjoy your program, you know?
Yeah, what part of Jamaica are
you?
Where? No, where are you?
Spanish Town.
Okay, yeah, man.
I'm there, I listen to your program, and I listen to your friend there, Carly, you know, I'm seeing no much.
Who that?
You're no much mind.
No, you see,
I understand, but I'm listening to you time, man.
She's a bait, you know?
Sometimes she doesn't have nothing constructive.
No, well, she's a bait, that's a bait.
Yeah. What may I say now, Jerry? Yeah? Well, I don't know, Mr. But politicians, they don't really like Jamaican. They don't really like reason, but they just fun, but they don't really they don't like what you got it. They want to use us. When we look at Mr. Really,
you know,
the
Pandas
side right now.
But
when Mr.
PJ Patton. When Mr. who? When Mr. PJ Patton Prime Minister, what happened?
Yes, and him pension. The money when collect pension, him
out. Talk up louder, man.
No, when I say him collect his same pension.
Yes, money. Yes.
His same PFP pension.
Yes, yes.
And you know, see that's not good.
No, he organized it.
Right, and you know, that's not good, Jerry, right? That's then, you know, and look, we have small people.
No, I'm not, them not no mercy. You know, you're him name.
Mercy, that's right.
Where him name? Percy, him name, you know. No mercy.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, so, you know, think people should not kill themselves for them. Politicians are not going like, say, well, boy, them are God, or them with me.
Let me say this now. So if people shouldn't kill up themselves over them, and if they have no mercy, what people should be doing is looking around in their community
right.
and their constituency and finding a list, making out a list about 20 people,
yeah.
male and female, throughout the constituency and the area, who could likely serve as a representative for the area. Because not one person can qualify now. Many people in all communities are qualified, could represent you.
Yeah.
You pick out about 20 or 40, and then you try to put them up to run as MP, or put them up to run as councillors, and little by little you're going to learn how to take control from Percy, Worcy and Stercy. Thank you very much, here.
Yeah, man.
Next one. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello.
Good morning.
Ah, Wagwan.
Whenever the PNP is campaigning, you see,
yeah.
I want them to stop talk about Siaga and some long-time jail because it's Andrew only that I want to see now.
Andrew Wolness is the person who's going to supervise the Labour Right Party.
Why am I going? I'm going to run him out?
No, I'm going to, whenever I win the next general election.
I'm out on the construction, bro.
When I'm going to win the next general election, I'm going to supervise the party. He will be the edge supervisor.
Yeah.
It's not going to be Bruce Golding, it's not going to be Edward Sierra. So stop using those old people's names. A new thing is going on now.
Yeah.
Andrew Wolness is coming in with fame style of leadership. Fame, Una style. And I think him have a very good style, because I read something about what he plans to do when he becomes the Prime Minister. So Jamaican people should go there and vote for Andrew Wolness in the next general election.
All right, let me ask you this. Yeah, can I ask you something? Is he going to come with the same undated letters technique again?
What?
Undated letters of appointment to the Senate, or undated letters of resignation from the Senate, presumably.
No, man, him learn more now.
How you know? Has he made any statement about that?
Yeah, man, him learn.
I said, has he made any statement about that?
That him learn?
Has he made any statement that he will not again... Stop, talk, and listen. Has he made any statement that he will...
But I know.
Stop, talk, and listen. Has he made any statement that he will not demand letters to be signed to any senatorial appointees to be signed with any resignation not dated so that he can remove them or attempt to remove them, which he may not do? It has already been demonstrated that he was wrong. Has he made any statement against any such...
No, he never made a statement.
All right, thank you very much. Call again soon. Next one. Morning, welcome straight up, hello.
Yes, morning, Jerry.
Wagwan.
Yes, man, I'm going to talk something different now.
Yeah.
The other night, a man came on a TV. I don't think it was a Jamaican. But
yeah.
He had some plastic bottles. I was showing how you could make a mask with a trap.
Okay.
And I think that was very innovative.
Yes, it was.
Because there's a place that I was cleaning up. A business place.
Yeah.
And people too, and when I counted 15 drink bottles, the plastic ones, that they throw in my place. And hear me to myself. People who are through these people, where they don't throw in a film yard, to say yard are in a film roadside. Where do I throw from my roadside where I clean up all the way? And also, where they don't use it as a man to make some traps that I can kill it where they must get it. But the next thing, no, Jerry. I heard someone on the TV say the TV same thing because they can't approve it or what. And the man also pointed out that the mosquito tend to go towards warm blood and warm people. And I am telling this, Jerry. I have if you wear a coat, a part of your garment, like a shirt and so, a hang it up anywhere, when you look, especially if I'm sweating it and I wash the same thing, you see the mosquito and come down and they make it close.
Yeah, because they are attracted to the smell.
Exactly. But you see your personnel was talking, said they don't know nothing. So if you don't know, shut them out because...
No, you can't tell somebody if them don't know, shut them out. People are going to talk that they don't know, so they have to open their mouth and say, I don't know.
Well,
probably the person says, I don't know anything about that. I don't believe that. And people don't must believe things and just swallow, you know.
But I can affirm that it's true.
Yes, but people have to be assured and it has to be demonstrated to people. People don't feel swallowed.
All right. Last thing, Jerry. The same plastic bottle and the styrofoam containers.
Yeah.
You remember, Jerry, you remember when, man, people used to make some kind of thing with a packet, they call it a packet, and go there and eat it at it.
Yeah.
Tree,
yes.
And then they go the thing.
Yeah, calabash.
Yes, calabash.
Yeah.
And the money got them grown, and it is
to. And what are you suggesting about the package, Shell?
People have come back to these things.
So you are suggesting that people who have fast food joint and thing.
Yes.
Must pack up a whole heap of calabash thing and they serve the fast food in it and send it away in the fast food.
Nothing wrong with that.
Well, hold on. And when the people them put on them food at a bus stop, a wait pan bus, and they pack it round, the bottom round, and it swing over some turn over them food. I am not suggesting that styrofoam and flat bottom. Hold on, listen to me now.
Yes, go on.
I am not suggesting that styrofoam and flat bottom box is the only answer, you know.
Yes.
But any solution must be more practical than the problem. A solution can't be less practical than the problem.
But Jerry, you, a man can use his brain and do something with the pocket that's the wrong part.
Yeah, but
you can fashion it. People can design things.
Yes, it's true.
You understand what I mean? But yeah. I'm saying, look how it was.
Yeah, but you can't go back to the future, you know.
Yes, and in my first time when people go market, man, and they had them banker, and they have it for years, and they come to buy them banker.
And what must they do now?
I know everybody got plastic bag.
Yeah, starting with your leader.
Yeah, but I'm telling you something, man.
Plastic.
And this is what this thing not going to disintegrate.
All right, anyway, at least you are applying your mind to the problem, but thank you very much, yeah?
Good, man.
Thank you very much. Next one, please. Good morning. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up Hello. Next one, please. Any more there? Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up Hello. Are you there? Look around the numbers, please.
Jerry, how are you? Good morning.
Welcome, sir. How are you doing?
I give that. When you hear me call you from there, I listen to the same way, you know?
Oh, yeah.
And what are you doing when I have to listen and learn?
Yeah,
and
yeah.
That listen that you gave us. You give it before, you know.
Which one? Which one?
The Bob Marley thing there.
Yeah.
And so forth. Because some of us, I am in a run of survey, have an idea of what happened.
Yeah.
But we don't know to the fullest or to the magnitude of what really took place. And yeah. Who, you know?
Yeah.
Where boy have come up. But, and you have retained those things clearly.
Some of them are just verified. Because.
Here you go. Right. For instance, when even just a while ago, when the gentleman asked something and the other, and you asked the question, is Mr. Onis going to have them same undated letter there and things to continue?
Yeah.
What do you mean? Those are the questions that I asked. Then the other thing is integrity. You know, we hear about integrity commission and things like that.
Yeah.
And most of them, you can't just give me a quick thing about integrity, Jerry.
Well, integrity is the idea that the wholesomeness of something or somebody is complete.
Mm-hmm.
And integrated, meshed together, integrated, mm-hmm. You know. And they fit together completely. It's not a contrast or a contradiction. Or like say, yeah, watch the cork, the things leak. And meanwhile, yeah, watch the cork, the bung a leak. So
yes,
like...
Can I just say, is it something of a high standard?
Yes, integrity is guaranteed by high standards. Otherwise, integrity is not there.
All right. So now, we come to the point quickly now. When these parties, I don't know if it's both of them or one of them, that they have integrity commission.
Yeah.
It's just loose words being used loosely.
We allow them to use them loosely, or we can hold them to their word.
Yeah. That is so clear for the common man to know.
Yeah.
And you see, when I just started calling this program,
and
I used to say to you, boy, you know, Jerry, I hear you a long, long time, and you're a good, great historian. I didn't use the word political historian, but a historian in general.
Yeah.
You said to me, you know, I hear that. You just do your thing. Now you talk about that. So you have never really I have never heard it, to come forward and say, you are this great historian, or you're this great guru, or you're this great what?
Mm.
You understand?
Well, your
knowledge that you have displayed tell people say you are good and great in
eyes. No, I don't display no knowledge. I display information and it's up to the people who see the display or hear it to test it.
There you go. Thank you very much.
And therefore, just like how people can frame you that you claim to be a great political scientist, people can also frame you to be PNP and frame you to be JLP. Like but if you have any integrity, you cannot be contained in any frame.
There you go. Thank you very much, my brother.
I thank you. Next one, please. Good morning. Welcome to Straight Over. Yes, welcome.
Morning.
Wagwan.
I hear people talking about when Bruce Coleman was going to stop him PJ Patterson pension. But right now...
You heard that? I never hear anybody say that.
But right now, PJ...
Hold on. When you heard people say that?
So what?
People, that Bruce Golden was going to stop PJ pension.
Then I remember when Bruce Golden was just coming, he was trying to stop it.
I don't remember that.
That is too big.
Remind me.
That is too big.
Remind me. Tell me some more.
Crime.
Remind me. Tell me some more about it.
I don't remember so much about it.
Then who remind you about it?
I remember when Mr. Golden come in and...
Yes, and tell me what you remember about it.
Mr. Golden was wanting to cut it.
You're repeating the same thing. Tell me something more and different.
I don't remember nothing.
You don't remember anything. Somebody remind you.
Nobody remind me.
Well, you don't remember anything?
But I'm talking about pension.
Yeah.
You know, Mr. Bruce Golden, now he's working at the university.
Yeah.
And I believe when he leaves there, he will get a pension.
From who?
From the university.
Where you get that from?
Then if you work in another place, a big place like the University of the West Indies, as a doctor, you're not supposed to get pension from there.
And Bruce Golden is working as a doctor?
He's not working as a doctor, but he have a contract there, he works with the university.
You know of him having a contract here?
Don't you work in there?
I'm asking if you know of him having a contract here.
If he work in there, he must have a contract.
So everybody who work on contract?
Well, you have a contract at the university.
If you mind your own business, you would learn more. And you would not presume so much foolishness. You're talking a lot of foolishness. You, Wilson, is a sensible person, talking a lot of foolishness.
But I believe most of our contract is working on...
I know you believe that. Yeah. You also...
Yeah, I was working on a contract.
Yes, you believe any foolishness?
That couldn't be foolishness, Mr.
Yeah.
If you're working there, you must have a contract. How much years you working for? And so on.
Yeah, you believe any foolishness? Are you going to continue?
I believe. That I don't know. Correct me.
All right.
What are you working at?
I'm going to correct you with one question. Do you not believe in ghosts?
Ghost?
Yeah.
You believe the dopey them out here?
Yes. Well, we need to go no further. You and the dopey them have a contract.
You go on.
If you violate it, dog, near me supper. You go on. You go on fool around them. And pay the Obia man. Go on, you go on with Obia man money and believe in Obia.
Explain to me, oh Golden.
No, I'm not going to be able to explain to you until your mind, until the darkness, the veil lift off of your mind. May we have another call, please?
Hello?
Not lion. It's a lion, of course, but Alan. Alan the lion. Alan Cole is here. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up.
Yes, Mr. Jerry. I heard you talk about things to that state.
Are you the man from Plowden? Hold on a minute. Alright, cut him then. No, I hear me. Let him go back to hell. I don't want to hear it.
Hello?
Good morning and welcome to Straight Up.
Hello?
Good morning, welcome.
Yes, Jerry. Have you ever heard the saying, a butu in a bend is always a butu?
I take it from you as a butu.
No, I think that best applies to you. Why are you so coarse and callous to the caller?
You see, because I'm a butu in a Benz.
Okay, well, I'm glad at least you acknowledge some comment that is labeled on you.
Yes, I acknowledge it.
You are too coarse and you need proper decorum when conducting
the
radio.
Yes, but I'm not going to refine myself for your sake. I don't need any connection or anything.
You refine yourself for my sake, just for the Jamaican people who you interact with daily.
No, hear me now. You're not going to lecture me. I'm going to give you 2 minutes more. Let's go for a break. Come back and use the 2 minutes properly. Welcome back to Straight Up. Are you there, sir?
Hello, yes, I'm still here.
Yes, go ahead. Are you still in the Benz?
No, listen to me, Mr. Small. You're decorum and radio right now. You must be politically aligned while you are still alive.
And who you think I'm aligned with? Tell me who you think I'm aligned with.
Must be the party that your brother who forsake this country and was such a laughing stock within Parliament was aligned to.
Yeah, he was a laughing stock in Parliament?
Indeed.
In which year?
Indeed.
In which year? Which year
I'm
was that?
I'm not so good with.
No, that showed you are no good. You are not. It's not. Not
draw my tongue.
No, it's not. Not so good.
Draw my tongue in the 2 minutes.
Draw it. I draw it. You are not only not so good. You are no good when it comes to memory and facts. No good. What year was you, Small, a laughing stock in Parliament?
He was indeed a laughing stock.
All right. On what topic? Okay. He was a laughing stock on the subject of what?
On the subject of justice.
Now tell me about it. Tell us more about it.
Okay, Mr. Smart.
No, tell me more about you, Smart, okay, being a laughing stock on the subject of justice. Because come.
You and Lambert, bro.
No.
The same identical.
No, tell me more about you, Small, being a laughing stock on the subject of justice.
To carry me down any road that I wish not.
Get rid of him.
Down.
Call back again Monday. Get rid of him. But he knows nothing. He's not only not so good, he's no good. But we love the whole of them still now. But he's no good, no good. Next call. Quick. Good morning.
Hello?
We have Alan Cole here. We're going to get rid of them. Call her quick. Good morning.
Hello.
Welcome, sir.
Yeah. Morning, sir, Smart.
Yes, man. No, you don't have to put on a sorry, but I understand you still.
Yeah. Look, what you have to understand is, you know.
Yes, sir.
What those people really want for you,
yes,
to do,
yes,
is stop more in favor for them and don't be partial.
I know.
Because I listen to the program and I notice the type of people who always, you know,
yes,
come down on you.
Yes.
That way, saying, you know, you're more on that.
Yes.
But we there here and we hear you, Ash, both of them.
Yeah.
But only thing that I say still, whether I don't hear you encourage or talk about much greatness.
Which
both sides. As there must be something good.
Since there must be something good, could you name one thing good about the JLP, please?
Give me one thing good about the JLP.
You're fumbling, man.
No, the thing is...
Alright, no, not the thing is. Okay, name one thing good about the PNP, please.
No, I didn't really call.
I can't really... I have given credit to both of them, you know, at times. But you are saying that I'm not doing it at all. I'm asking you to name one good about one, your fumble. I asked you to name
If I said not at all, then...
Yeah.
My bad about that.
All right. Look here, we're short of time because Alan Cole in the house. You have 1 more minute. Go ahead.
Yes. The other thing is, you see, since to me and probably the general public,
yeah,
Mr. Olney seems that he's coming with a different type of politics, right? So I think within in that case, knowing that he doesn't have anything where you can align him to say, you know, negative,
yeah,
I think probably you could encourage him.
Encourage him. Me, Jerry Small.
You could
encourage him. Hold on there. Me, Jerry Small, could encourage him.
Mr. Small, you're living in a country where we have leaders.
A joke, you make. He's your leader. He's your leader. He's not my leader. He could never be my leader.
Mr. Small?
He's not my leader. Look here. Call me Monday. Next one. Call me Monday. Monday you call me. Please. With all respect.
Good morning,
with all respect. Yes, Mr. Yes, sir. Wagwan, sir.
How are you?
Why, a long time, man.
Yes, man. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
But I tell you, boy, I enjoy your program so much.
True, man.
You don't think that I don't call you, you know, man.
Yes, man.
But sometimes I get busy, you know, Jerry.
Yes, sir.
Good and so on.
Like, you get busy like busy, Campbell.
Yes. And good morning to my good friend, Alan Cole. Actually, I met him through you, you know.
Yeah?
Jerry, yes. You remember
place here? Open day, yes.
Yes.
Yeah,
you know,
man.
I met him through you.
You have 1 more minute?
Yes. Look here now, the music that you played that you opened the show with yesterday,
yeah,
was so good.
What name again?
Man and Woman in the Street.
Man and Woman in the Street.
Yes.
Street corner and Man in the Street.
You know,
yes,
that I'm a music addict, you must know,
yes,
that by now.
Yes, sir.
You are very addicted to music, you know?
Yeah.
I thought of music. And
yeah,
I just like all the music that you play.
Yeah,
Jerry?
Yeah.
Yes, and I just enjoy the program and so on. Good?
Well, thank you very much.
Good, so you take care of yourself.
Yes, sir, I'm asking you to big up your wife, please, sir.
Yes.
All right.
You know?
Yes, sir. Next one.
And I'm bigger up, yes.
Yes, sir.
Good then, sir.
Good morning. You don't need no help with that, man. You can manage that. Good morning and welcome to Straight Up. Hello? We have 2 more. Morning, good morning, welcome. Go ahead, please. All right, make way here. Start over.
Yeah, Mr. Mayor, listen to it.
Go on.
Under labor rights government, America have to send fees.
We do this.
Let me check it out.
Yeah.
In this late 70s to 80, Anthony Brown and Charles are sending the Panim police most wanted. What the PNP government do with them, Mr. Mayor?
What them do with them?
Yeah, they don't carry them go to Cuba, go put them down.
They carried them to Cuba, they made their...
Yeah, they Michael Manley carried them to Cuba.
Yeah? Hold on. He accompanied them to Cuba?
Me, yes, Michael Manley didn't carry them, go left them at Cuba.
Yeah, but you will hear anything in a bar, you know?
So
Them money can take care of themselves, man. You're a joker. Them take care of Michael Mann, and Michael Mann take care of them.
No, but when they wanted and most wanted,
then you wrong them. Then you wrong, hold on, you wrong them for move.
Well,
if the CIA, hold on.
If
the CIA is after you, you wouldn't move.
Well.
And when the KGB after me, me move.
Yeah.
I don't wrong them. Call me again, money. I need to talk to you some more.
Respect.
You have another one?
Yeah, my dad.
Welcome, welcome. Another one? Good morning. Welcome to Straight Up. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, sir. Welcome.
Good morning. Mr.
Smart. Mr. Fagan, that?
Yeah, man.
Well, we now go here for talk long this morning. Go ahead, please.
Okay.
No, you're not ready, Mr. Fagan. Look here, call me Monday. No, call me Monday, Mr. Fagan. Please, I want to give some more time. You can't get no time this morning, but you need more time. You deserve more time than what I can give you now. Look here from Jerry Butler.
All right.
Jerry Butler.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Jerry Butler, Jerry Butler. Yes, Alan Cole coming up. Just like how them try frame it, send me a GLP. And then hey, don't cut me out. Then try frame me. Some idiot. I don't know good cabinet maker, you know. Can't make a good frame. Trying to frame me, say me a labor, right? Trying to frame me, say me a comrade. Them try frame Alan Cole too. Them try frame Bob Marley too. Only the strong survive. Jerry Butler. Straight.
I remember my first love affair. Somehow or another the whole darn thing went wrong. But my mama had some great advice, so I thought I'd put it in the words of this song. I can still hear her saying, boy,
boy, boy.
Oh, I see it sitting out there all alone, crying your eyes out, cause the woman that you love is gone. Oh, there's gonna be a whole lot of trouble in your life. So listen to me, get up off your knees, cause only the strong survive. That's what she said, only the strong survive. Only the strong survive. Yeah, you gotta be strong. You better hold on. Don't go around with your head hung down. Well, I wouldn't let the little girl know. She made me feel like a clown. There are a whole lot of girls.
I see you sitting there all alone.
Yes, me I tell you about that. No, Alan Cole, me I tell you. Look how much thing them try frame you with. Eliza? I know you don't like talk about yourself too much, but look how much they don't try frame you with.
That is life, Jerry.
Yes, sir,
life.
Yeah, man. And 1976, when them a plan for back up Bob Marley. Earlier than that, them plan for back up you and you take off. You shift them and you only a foolish dog bark at a flying bird. You represent the flying bird. When me little boy I grew up a country, no? Me in the yard, 3, 4, 5 year old, me in the yard, I'm a dog, I run up and down, me look, it's a shadow. The junk or shadow, a fly cross, and the dog, I run up and down after it all day. Foolish dog. Now, 76, when them come for you, Eilston Road, are you them a try frame, you know? You didn't know?
No, I wasn't, yeah.
You did gone already? Yeah. You gone already, but them a try frame, you. Them move against it, claim say, through 12 try, won't endorse them state of emergency and the heavy manners. Them say we is a threat, and them come hold 92 of we carry on no man land, claiming some man amongst us with this, that, and that. Now, you's a man, you's one of the first man we can drive from concrete jungle to Tivoli Garden, and carry a man go down there, and nobody can do nothing, and sit in, and then pick up man and carry go to Tivoli Garden, up to concrete jungle, and everybody have those hold in peace. You have that kind of freedom of movement, and you can even carry people with you, and them have a whole fire. Politicians don't like when them say two young men in a country have them kind of power now. One entertainer and one sportsman. And the two of them are two best friends. What say you?
Well, I don't think we're all that civilized in that particular part of history or people were, you know, too politicized.
Yeah, yeah.
And as I say, we weren't all that civilized.
Yeah. But you're moving up and down that way is an exercise in civilization.
That's right. That's
you
right.
Must have a no man's land, a place where all fire must hold, a space between the two front lines, where no conflict and no hostilities must take place.
Well, that's how life should be. You know, we didn't have no borderline.
Exactly.
In terms of how we don't have no borderline.
No.
I go anywhere.
Exactly.
And I talk to anybody.
And when you don't have no border line, you won't have no border clash.
Yeah, well, you know. Because we relate to people.
Yes.
And we know how to deal with the youths and
yes,
things like that. So
then you have more experience in that and your coach Bob Marley, you know that. I'm getting more and more expertise. Especially 76.
As I said, you know, that period of time the people were so dormant.
Yeah.
Those what you call them now, followers.
Yeah, yeah.
And you know, you have to just live on and forgive people.
God
has said, because our people, them still.
Yes, sir.
And just a misunderstanding.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, because
that means anything can be overcome.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to go for a break now. We'll come back down. Just a little 15 minutes left. But this won't be the last of our interaction with Alan Cole in a Black History Month, in a Reggae Month. Straight up. You're too rude and we too rude because as Alan Cole was saying to me, we the people, I ain't not doing it but I still include myself sometimes like other people do. We not take care of our own public health you know, and this dumping of garbage in a gully and the people have to start taking care of themselves. Or you expect, not two things, you know, them expect government to come do everything and when government come to something now, government to give them the job and pay them to do it. Some self-help, but I want to get back to Alan Cole you now. I never realized, by the way, I was supposed to interview Sister Judy, you know, but I never get to edit it and I don't want to play the whole thing raw because I was talking about our experience, with, you know, and I'm going to play it next week, probably not 2 or 4. But me, I tell you, say, you were away when the peace concert, when the Smile Jamaica concert go on. And as I think we have discussed before, I'm sure that if you was there and Bob did have a side of him, he would have get a little safer. But I understand that when he was rehearsing Smile Jamaica and rehearsing the song, Smile You're in Jamaica, there was a lyric in there say, Heavy Manners in Jamaica, and not even realizing say, it's a political lyric, somebody should be in there. You know? And at the last minute, a certain lady said to him, said, can't go with that lyric now. As on that make him pull out. You know? Can you imagine the consequence of that if he could sing that?
Well, as I say, that particular time, that's 76.
Yes, man.
And that's it's almost 40 years ago.
Yeah.
The level of understanding was very, very, very low.
Yes.
At that time.
Yes.
So, you know. Would have caused some conflict.
Yes, man. And then, not only you are away, him other close friend, Claudia Massop, is incarcerated. So he don't have the guidance of Claudia. Or he don't have Claudia for hold back the forces neither. Because I think he's under the same state of emergency. Claudia Massop might have been confined or you know.
Well, Massop was in jail before that. He was charged for murder.
Oh, yes, yes.
So he was at the gun court at that time.
Yeah.
When they were rehearsing for the show.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I was told after that by Bob that during the week of the incident, people passed by and were passing sound and they never take it serious.
Yeah, warning sounds.
Yeah.
Even some of our 12 tribe brethren are warned.
Yeah.
But there was nobody around to really talk about.
Yeah, that's him would hear.
And when I was told this, it was after the incident, and I asked him, why anybody tell me? You know?
Yeah.
They might take it too serious.
Yes. Now, this labeling and framing of people and all that kind of way is a thing that people just do lightly, but them don't know that, them don't realize the consequence of it. But they don't care. Matter of fact, I think they calculate on the consequence of it.
Some people don't understand.
Yeah.
And some people don't really care. And that is one of the that has been a problem through the years.
Yeah.
And still is.
Now, Louis Griffiths, him got shot to at Bob Place. That was a young artist amongst 12 tribe. He was quite good.
Yeah.
And he have a style, he have a self-confidence style on the stage there. He not talk loud, you know.
Yeah.
Remember that man, he not talk loud, you know.
I think he's a queer rant here.
Eh?
Yeah.
Talk down them throat and sing down them throat, but he have a lovely style. And then now, Dan Taylor also got shot.
Dan was the man who went in front of Bob and took the shots of Bob.
Yeah, yeah.
When Bob gets shot, Bob, he was cornered.
Yes.
And the man started one shot at him.
Yeah.
And then went in front of him and took all those shots.
Yes,
same shot.
Yeah. And yesterday, Sister Judy was reminding me about how similar situation like Smile, but not similar. Similar situation in terms of political involvement, but it work a different way. Smile Jamaica, he wanted to perform for the people of Jamaica. And the government said, okay, we will help you with the infrastructure and the venue.
Well, let me tell you all about that. This is so that both of us planned a year before.
Long before?
Yeah, because what I'm after, it was getting all these good reviews in Europe.
Yeah.
And we weren't doing any show. From the last show we did was Stevie Wonder, I think it was. So after we did the Stevie Wonder show, we performed for quite a while. And getting all these good reviews in Europe, you know, we decided, say we're going to do a free show. And we planned a free show that to be done right after that tour in 1976. So what happened is after the tour finished, after we finished that world tour and the US tour, we decided, we had a meeting, myself, Dan Taylor and Bob, we had this meeting after the tour. And I was saying that we were informing Dan that we planned the show, because Dan didn't know about the show. It was just both of us had the idea. So we were informing Dan that we had the show planned to take place this year. It was 76.
Yeah.
So what happened now is that after what was happening and the heat and all the everything that was happening, I just said to them, well, I'm not coming down right now, so
yeah,
just be very careful. Because the election here.
Yes.
That's the exact thing I told you.
Yeah.
So what happened is that now, there was nobody around. I said nobody around. No one who was there that could say, well, this can't be done, this shouldn't be done, or whatever.
Yeah.
Because the heat at the moment is that some people start jumping into the bandwagon.
Yeah.
And that personal ambition, personal intention.
Mm-hmm.
And then it got away like it was getting political. Which now, truth and the fact, it was nothing like that. Because we just playing a free show for the people here.
Yeah.
So when it got to that stage now, the heat of the campaign and all of that now, people started to get away.
Yes.
And nobody was there to say, well, you know, let us solve the problem. Let us deal with it and cool it down so, you know, nobody don't get offended.
Yeah.
Nobody was there to say nothing. And even the week of the show, Bob came and looked for me in New York. I said, everything all right, he said, yeah, everything all right. And never said nothing. It's the night of the shooting, you know, Bingo and some of the men in my car started telling me what transpired in the week before the show. And
yeah,
then when I went and looked for him and Dan in Miami at the hotel, because I distinctly warned them, and I said, yeah, we have to be very careful.
Yeah.
The election year.
Because you know the warning signs.
You know, and I tell them, say, I'm not going to be there, so be careful.
Unlike this election year, it was a long, stretched out campaign, eight months and more.
Yeah. So, like, even, and I said, you have to be very careful.
Yeah.
And you know, when I went to the hospital in Miami, I saw Dan Taylor and Bob and, you know, And I went in the room and I said, well, man, I said, I want nothing of you, careful. Be careful, have to know what they're doing.
Yeah.
But, you know, like I said, if they had said something to me during the time when all these things got going, I'd have told them, said, you know.
You could have evaluated and veto it.
And yeah, that ends it, okay, the show. Yeah, that would have been the best thing.
Yeah, because a rat race where you help for right.
Yeah.
Is warning of this situation.
That was the year before. Yeah, that's a warning because that idea came from the political
tension of the time.
And so we got this idea, and so
Now talking about political tension at the time, idea, and show and government backing show. The other side of the coin now is Zimbabwe attaining independence through freedom fighting.
Yeah.
And saying we want Bob Marley at our liberation show and concert.
Well, let me tell you how that happened. When he came to Africa, you know,
and you were an idiot.
Yeah, ZANU and ZAPU, those are the two parties that were
fighting
for independence.
Yes,
Nkrumah and Mugabe.
Yeah.
So what I mean, we were very close to the Virgin them there.
Yeah.
I was very close to them, and as Rastan and Jamaica, and them check for me. Because them say Rastaman and Jamaica in general, right?
Yeah.
The greatest people on earth, because we support this struggle from another.
Yeah.
So me and the Virgin was very, very close. Mm. So when we went there, I pick up Bob at the airport, me and Bob and Flippins and all the Virgin. And Flippin gave him the song in my room, and the Virgin were there.
Give him the song, Zimbabwe.
Yes, yeah, and Flippin pick it on the guitar, and then Bob said, "Jeez, give me this guitar.
Yeah.
This is a hit song."
Yeah.
And the Virgin get excited and say, "Boy, this is a thing for the independence." And them say, well, let's step it up. And then they start to say, well, you know, we get independence, so we want it to come to Zimbabwe to perform for independence. And that's how everything came into being, right there, you know. Right in El Sabab, right inside of the apartment. And everything, all the hookup was me, because I said, both of the liberation group.
At that time, your control apartment in Addis.
Yeah, that time I was living in Revolution Square. I was coaching at that time. So, and we had just finished playing the Afro tournament in the final. So, this is where it all started, and that's how everything came into being. And,
yeah.
You know, the bridge, they were so excited at the time, but the song alone got them so excited.
Yeah, yeah.
That was a well-penned song.
Well, look here, this is Black History Month. You can't visit one time. You have to go continue this. And in that occasion now, the government financed some of the show, like what PNP did to 76.
Well, I don't think the government really financed it. Bob financed everything.
They don't want to carry Bob, but him said, boy, I do the 10% rent out all of the equipment.
Yeah, all the equipment, man.
And flight in.
Yeah,
tons of equipment.
Yes, he spent all that.
I want to thank my producer, Tanya Richards. I want to thank our new trainee production lady, Shavoya Fleming. I want to thank Bob Marley. I want to thank especially Philip Leach Flippins for this piece of music, Zimbabwe, straight.
Every man got the right to decide. It's a struggle, 'cause that's the only way we can overcome a little trouble.
Brother, you're right, you're right, you're right, you're right, you're so right.
We gon' fight,
we gon' fight,
we'll have to fight,
we gon' fight,
we gonna fight,
we gon' fight,
fight for our
Electoral Commission of Jamaica says it is ready for elections. Opposition leader Andrew Honus promises no income tax for teachers and nurses. Public access to Angels to Linstead leg of North-South Highway on Monday. And two gunmen killed and cops injured in St. Catherine shootout.